honor for me to be able to celebrate my mother-in-law's birthday. My mother-in-law's funeral. It's a little nervous, as you can see. Mother-in-law and I are just like a mother and a brother. I want to read the obituary. Catherine June Branham Williams was born in Jasonville, Indiana, July 24, 1924, to Tom and Elizabeth Marsh Branham, preceding in death by her husband of 39 years, Arthur Red Williams, Jr. One daughter, Jane Ann Williams Bell. One sister, Virginia Mae Jinx Adams. And one great-granddaughter, Kelly Ann Hunt. Survived by one daughter, Donna K. Dillard, and son-in-law, Neil. Two great-granddaughters, Felicia K. Page and husband, Denny Page. Kimberly Dawn White. Three grandchildren, Dennis Page, Kayla Ann Gross, and Amberly White, and two great-grandsons, Rylan and Cash Page, and one sister, Betty Jean Brown Wilson, and seven nieces and nephews. She had a large family, and the two youngest ones are living in Florida now. She retired from Holly April 1st, 1987. She worked there 33 years. She was a very, very tough lady. She worked hard. She survived the Depression. She survived the typhoid fever and Red service in World War II. And then the grand pandemic of 2020. Finally, she said, when she was in the hospital, she said, "It's time to go." Said, "I'm ready to go," and said, "I can't stand this anymore," and said, "I want all the IVs and everything taken out because I'm not going to lay here and just suffer and linger." So they took the IVs out and kept her calm, and she had a nice, peaceful death. She passed away nice. I wanted to read one little short verse right here before we get started with it. And it just real short. It says the days of our lives are 70 years. And if by reason of strength, they are 80 years. How strong would you have to be almost 97 years? And with what she had been through with and the sickness and all, she was a very, very strong lady. She loved to travel. And she wanted us to tell you about a little bit of the stuff that she did. She traveled to Jamaica with my wife. And every time they got on the bus, they said that somebody tried to sell them drugs, and they had to turn them down. She traveled to Mexico. She traveled to Canada. And my wife and my mother-in-law traveled to Europe on a special trip. And she said that she wanted to go over there to see, it's a good adventure, but she wanted to go over there and see where her husband had been during World War II. And that was her goal, to go over there and visit. Her and Red went to Hawaii on a vacation shortly after he got back, and she was always ready for a good adventure. If you could just give her anything that was fun, she was for it, and she loved people, and people loved her, and she was really dedicated and loved her family. On the, I called her one day, and I said, "How would you like to go to Maine and eat a lobster?" And she said, "I'm packing right now, and I'm ready to go." So we got ready, and I got my son-in-law and Kay and her, and we was going to Maine to eat lobster. We took the long route. We went by the Niagara Falls, and while we was there, water was rough and we was right up in the falls and it was bouncing around. And he looked at me and he ran over to me and I watched him. I was ready to jump in. And he grabbed me like this and he said, "Paul, this is awesome." And that's just memories that you'll never forget. You'd have to be there to recognize the memories that we have all made. And coming back, we took the long route back. We went over to Niagara Falls and watched the lights shine at night on the water. It was so beautiful. And then when we started back, we got off of the interstate in Troy. And we took all the back roads across Vermont, New Hampshire, Massachusetts, through there. And we got to Maine. And we found a place to get a lobster. And we went in this restaurant that was out on the, kind of hanging out over the beach, and ordered the lobster. But my grandson, he was probably 10 then, and he wanted oysters on a half shell. He loved them. So when the meal came, when they set it all out, they asked me first, said, "Do you want your lobster shucked?" And I didn't even know what he was talking about. When I found out what it was, they peeled it out and all you had was the meat. It cost another dollar or two, but you didn't have to pick that thing out. And they brought it, and when he dipped into his oyster, here comes this little varmint walking out of that thing and walking across the table. And I had no idea. He said, "Paul, what is this?" And it looked like a little clear spider with little legs on it. And I called the nurse out there, and I called the waitress over there. And I said, "Could you tell us what this is?" And she said, "Y'all are not from around here, are you?" And I said, "No, we're not." And she looked down at him and said, "Anytime you get raw oysters up here, they'll have little baby crabs in them a lot of times." And said, "They'll just come out and walk around." And he looked up at her and he said, "Well," he said, "just freak me out for a minute." And he started eating his oyster. But we'll never forget those kind of days. And we took the long way. Took the long way home, and we came by the Statue of Liberty, and we ferried to Delaware Bay, and went through the Bay Bridge Tunnel into Norfolk, and then came on home. Then, about 2 weeks later, we decided to take a trip to Washington State, and I called her again, and she said, "Yep, let's go." So we got in the car, and we went the scenic route across Montana, and we went to Washington State over the edge of Canada. Back through Iowa, and we took the back roads into Washington, into Seattle, and we went through the orchards, and they were absolutely beautiful. And we spent a lot of time with family there and then traveled back, came by Devil's Tower and a whole lot of places. So she traveled a whole lot, and I truthfully say she's been in all 50 states. And that's quite an accomplishment. When we went through Glacier National Park, we went through four seasons. In about 4 hours, when we started up, it was the fall. And when we got up to the top, it was snowing and it was winter. And as we started down the other side, it began the spring season. And when we got to the bottom, it was summer. I mean, it was just really a beautiful, beautiful trip. On our next trip, this was a good one. She was 70 years old and she wanted to take a hot air balloon. So for her birthday, Kay and I gave her a ticket to take a hot air balloon ride. We met the balloon in the parking lot at the Baptist Church. And we had to wait a while because you couldn't go up until the weather got 4 miles an hour or less. And when the weather got less, she crawled in, the pilot crawled in. She looked over at Kay and said, "Kay, somebody go with me." She said, "Neil, you go." So I got in that hot air balloon with her, and we took a ride, and we left the Baptist Church in the hot air balloon, and we went across country. You go the way the wind blows, but we went across country, and we landed where Felicia and Denny lived on the other side of the interstate from Richmond. And we really had a good crew. Sometimes he'd let it down, the bucket would tip, he'd go back up a little. And every time he would fire that thing to raise the bucket up, if you looked there, deer would run out of the fence ropes. And I said, "If anybody wants to go deer hunting, they need a hot air balloon and a high-powered rifle to kill all they want to." But that was a real good trip. It was a rough landing, but she hung in there and really good, had a good time. And then one day we decided that we need to go on one more long trip. So we drove to Alaska. And that is a long trip. We drove 9,969 across the Yukon, there was a place called Muppaluk Annie. And that's where we had his 12th birthday. He'll never forget it as long as he lived. They had a grill in there, and we had pink salmon. And I wasn't crazy about pink salmon, but to have a 12th birthday in the Yukon is something he'll never forget. So his memory, he's smiling now. I wanted him to get up here and talk about it, but he just said he didn't want to. But it was a fun time. He really enjoyed it. And when we got back, we were all tired, but we had a real good trip. Then I bought a camper, and we started camping quite a bit. We go to Branson and different places, and we camp out. And she loved that. We go fishing. I tried to get him to catch a beaver one time, and when I realized what it was, I was glad he didn't. We had a real fun camping. In 2007, after many strokes, she decided to move to assisted living, and she had said all of her life if she had to go to assisted living, she wanted to go to Bowling Green Retirement Village, which is chartered now. So she went in 2007, and she moved there, and she told us when she went in, said, "I'll be dead in 4 months." And she lived there 15 years. That's how tough she was. She lived 15 years. And this is pretty well celebration of life and love. It's not a time for crying. It's not a time for regrets. It's just a time to remember the good part of her life. Remember that how she treated her family, how she loved her family, how she worked hard. She accomplished a goal, and she got a lot out of life and a lot out of living, and she lived to be a long, long time. We want to thank Charter Senior Living for their years of care. They were really, really good to her. And we want to thank Hospice for their wonderful care, plus the many doctors and nurses. Thank you.
Walk in the pathway to you, and if I work to the close of the day, I shall see the great King in his beauty. When I've gone the last mile of the way, I will rest at the close of the day, and I know there are joys that await me when I've gone the last mile. Dearest of ties, we must suffer tears of sorrow are seen every day, but no sickness, no sighing forever. When I've gone the last mile, I will rest at the close of the day, and I know there are joys.
scripture. John 14, verse 1. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And where I go, you know, and the way you know. Bow with me, please. Our Father in heaven, we're thankful for this beautiful day that you have given us. You know, Father, our hearts are troubled. We have lost a great loved one. But we know, Father, that she's in good hands. Father, we just pray that you will take care of her. You'll guide her. You'll help her. We just pray that your will be done. In Christ's name we pray. Amen.
Just walked down the street to the coffee shop, had to take a break. I'd been by her side for 18 hours straight. Saw a flower growing in the middle of the sidewalk, pushing up through the concrete, like it was planted right there for me to see. The flashing lights, the honking horns all seemed to fade away. In the shadow of that hospital at 508, I saw God today. I've been to church, I've read.